Welcome to the Thargoid Report. I'm Commander Burr. This is a distillation of the excellent weekly thread from Burton Simmons on Reddit. For finer details on the why and the what of the Thargoids activity, then do give that post a look. I've linked it below. If you find this information useful and enjoy our content, then please consider giving the video a thumbs up and hit the subscribe button to make sure you see all our future videos. This week has seen another step change in the Thargoids activity, different from the usual patterns that we'd become accustomed to. Having suddenly withdrawn from the bubble last week with no new infestations being reported by Eagle Eye, the Thargoids have now directly attacked the planetary base of the engineer and xenoscientist Professor Palin in the Maya system. Well known for his experiments into all things Thargoid, we are left asking why suddenly the green meanies have turned their compound eyes toward him. Having forced the evacuation of the base on Maya A3A, the Goids appear to have pursued Palin to his megaship, the Carson Spring. As of this recording, if you visit the Professor's planetary base, you will be treated to multiple incoming attacks from Thargoid scouts exiting hyperspace in the airspace around the installation. It makes for some really unique combat and is, to my knowledge at least, not something we've seen before. Myself and Commander Aggregate Chip of the Burr Pit spent a happy 45 minutes or so above the installation fighting off wave after wave of scouts in lumbering T10s. I'd highly recommend grabbing some of that gameplay. We've no idea at this point how long the attack will go on. If you visit the Carson Spring, then be prepared for scouts and interceptors at the very least. From our limited exploration of the now freshly goided megaship yesterday, interacting with the ship in some way seems to initiate Thargoid activity in one form or another, so give it a poke if nothing shows up when you arrive. We're guessing, but it appears that the change in Thargoid activity seems to be linked to the current ongoing interstellar initiative, the Enclave. It's possible this may all be headed somewhere. The current phase of the community goal is scheduled to end early next week, so keep your ear to the ground for any sudden changes in the landscape. As for the rest of the galaxy, the following stations were attacked by Thargoids this week and are currently on fire and subject to ongoing rescue operations. Titan's Daughter in Taygeta, Cavalieri in Electra, and Cyllene Orbital in Atlas. The AXI is asking that pilots please focus their efforts on Titan's Daughter and Cavalieri as a matter of urgency. Also, it's worth checking out the Discord for the Post-Disaster Evacuation Service, which is an entire community dedicated to conducting rescue operations from the Thargoid affected stations. There you'll find advice and be able to link up with other commanders participating in the relief efforts. Their Discord is linked below. As well as evacuating civilians from these stations, you can also help delivering food, water, basic medicines and natural fabrics to the affected stations. If you are going into a burning station, bring all the heatsinks. Links to my previous videos on this subject are below. As of this recording, the Eagle Eye sensor network is still reporting no activity detected from all of its listening posts. If you're looking to attack scouts, then non-human signal sources in the Pleiades region or Palin's planetary installation are probably your best bet. Remember, if you are engaging in anti-Thargoid scout combat operations, you don't necessarily need any specialised equipment, but the entry level anti-xeno weaponry requires no unlocking and it really helps. The scout class vessels also count as elite ranked ships, so this is an excellent way to level up your combat rank. For the more hardcore combat zone encounters, the following systems are under Thargoid incursion right now and will have combat zones that offer both scouts and larger Thargoid vessels. Electra, Taygeta and Atlas. For the scouts and the death daisies, I'd recommend decontamination limpets are added to your standard arsenal and you might want to think about taking shedloads of heatsinks as well. The cone sector critters will struggle to track you when you're cold. With the assistance of the AXI Discord, all the systems I've listed this week are now presented in priority order. And if you're looking to wing up with other commanders then there's links below to the AXI, the Hive and the Hand. Between them these organisations have all platforms covered, they're a really friendly bunch and whatever your level of competence they'll help you fight bugs. Wherever you go commanders, remember, pick your fights with care. If you want to get involved with repair efforts and help get damaged stations back online after an attack then head over to the Operation IDA Discord. IDA coordinate the rebuilding efforts for the wider galactic community and will have you covered on where to go and what to bring with you. All you need is a galactic map and a few cargo racks. They're also linked below. That's it for now. Thank you so much for making it this far. You can also find us on Twitter, Patreon, Discord and Instagram. Links to all those are in the description below and I'll be back later this week with more videos. Until then, 07 Commanders, may all your hype addictions be brief and don't let the danger daffodils give you nightmares. I very much look forward to seeing you next time.